Hi everyone, it's Deeksha from Bonsai Labs. Welcome to the JavaScript series. This video today covers the stepwise approach on how to insert an array in the middle of an existing array. And we can do that using spread element in ES6. So let's dive into the details. Here is our problem statement. We have two different arrays containing GPAs of students in English language. Our goal is to insert English 2 GPA array in the middle of English 1 GPA, such that the result looks like this. All the elements from English 2 GPA array are inserted in the middle. The focus of this video is to work on the approach to solve a problem, and we will do that in three simple steps. So first thing, we need a way to find the middle position in an array. Next, we also need to find if array provides a method to add elements in place. And finally, we need a way to open up all the elements from English 2 GPA inside English 1 GPA array. We will do all of that one by one. There exist different ways to find the middle index in a given array, but one of them is by using this piece of code. Dividing the array length by 2 gives us the middle index of the array, but the length of the array could be an even or an odd number, and we want the resulting index to be an integer. And math is a built-in object in JavaScript that can help us doing that. Floor method, when applied on math object, returns the largest integer, which is either less than or equal to the number passed as an argument. So the middle index of an array that has a length of 5 returns 2, and the one with length 6 returns the middle index equals 3. Now our second step is to identify a way such that we could add elements at a specific position in an existing array. Splice is a method that can help us do that. It takes three parameters: a start index to indicate where to start from, delete count indicating the number of items to delete starting from the start index, and items, which refers to the elements that should be added in sequence. Note that splice method modifies the original array. It doesn't return a new array with all the changes that we want. Finally, we must also know how to spread and open an array inside another array so that we can place elements at a position we found. Here comes the spread element in JavaScript, which allows an iterable like array to be expanded and opened inside the array literal. For example, if scores is an array, we can pretty much spread all the elements from scores into this new scores array literal by using the spread element, which is represented by three dots. And you will see that new scores now have all the elements from scores. So let's now stitch all these pieces together to solve our problem. All right, so time to write the code on the editor. We have two arrays already here. We are going to find the middle index of English 1 GPA array now. To find the middle index, we are going to name a variable middle index, and we will use math.floor as we saw previously, and we will pass as argument English 1 GPA length, and that has to be divided by 2 because we need to find the middle index. Once we have the middle index, now we are going to splice the English 1 GPA array. During splicing, we need to pass the first argument as start index, which is going to be the middle index. We want to start inserting the elements from this index onwards. 0 is the count, and we are going to spread English 2 GPA array. Now spread expands all the elements that were in English 2 GPA array right here. Now it's time to log the value of English 1 GPA array. Because we spliced it, we will do console.log English 1 GPA. All right, so let's run the program and see what the result is. If you notice, splice did change the original array, but we were able to insert English 2 GPA array starting from the middle index. So I hope you got the idea how to make use of math.floor to find the middle index, then splicing the array, and finally using the spread element to open up the elements inside the array. I hope this small session was helpful for you. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions, drop the comments. You may want to subscribe to this channel if you want to learn fast with these short videos. Until then, my friends, keep learning and share your knowledge.